For this new exercise 2.6, we have to discuss first equations reducible to the linear form. And especially in this chapter you have to study about cross multiplication. What is this? You can see there are two algebraic expressions written as a numerator and denominator. And how to solve this? You don't have any clue. Right now you can do one thing. If this is written a upon b and c upon d, so you can multiply this numerator by this denominator and this numerator by this denominator. Means multiply a into d and b into c and put a sign here of equality. Means multiply these terms and keep the sign equal. This is called cross multiplication here. And now see how to implement this in solving our questions. This is x plus 1 upon 2 x plus 3 is equal to 3 upon 8 cross multiplied. So 8 is now multiplying x plus 7. x plus 1 is equal to 3 is multiplying 2x plus 3. Okay. Now you can see your question is gonna be simplified. Your question is, now you can see one thing, your question is going to be simplified. Multiply this by 8. So 8 multiplies x becomes 8x and plus 8. Is equal to 3 to the 6x plus 9. 3 to the 9. Transpose this 3x to here. Sorry, 6x to left hand side, you will get 8x minus 6x is equal to 9 here. And when you transpose this 8 plus 8, it will become minus 8. And result is 2x is equal to 1. So you have x is equal to what? 1 upon 2. So we have to solve our questions in exercise 2.6 by this method. And here we have this exercise 2.6. And in classwork, our first question is 9x upon 7 minus 6x is equal to 15. How to solve this question? Now, for this second part, 15 can be written as 15 upon 1. Okay, I don't think, do you have any doubt? I don't think that you have doubt about this. Now multiply. Now do the cross multiplication and you will get what? 9x is multiplying 1 and this 15 is multiplying 7 minus 6x. You can write it 7 minus 6x into 15, no problem. It can multiply this, it can multiply this, no problem. You can follow any order, okay? Now it is 9x is equal to 15 7 ja 105 and 15 minus 6 90x, okay? Now go ahead, these are the like terms, so keep aside. 9x and transposing 90 becomes 90x and with plus sign, and this is 105 and here it is 99x is equal to 105. X is equal to what? 105. When you divide by 99 both the terms, you will get 105 upon 99 here, and here 99 is cancelled. So this is our answer. You can reduce in its lowest form by dividing by 3. So this will be 3 3 is a 9 and this is 35 and this is what? 33. This is your answer. We have second part, which is question number 4. 3y plus 4 upon 2 minus 6y is equal to minus 2 upon 5. How to solve this question? So again cross multiplication. Okay, keep this sign equal in the mid. So 3y plus 4 into 5, okay, is equal to minus 2 is multiplying 2 minus 6y. One more thing I would like to tell you here. You can multiply 5. You can write it 5 into 3y plus 4. Or you can write it 3y plus 4 into 5. So we have an idea here. This time you can multiply this 5 here. Multiply by 5 this plus this. So 5 into 3 becomes 15y and प्लस 5 4 20 इज इक्वल टू व्हाट, माइनस 4 एंड प्लस 12y. ओके, माइनस 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 एंड प्लस बिकम्स माइनस एंड 2 2 4 एंड माइनस बिकम्स प्लस, माइनस 2 इंटू 6 बिकम्स माइनस 2 इंटू माइनस इट बिकम्स 12y. नाउ सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन, यू विल गेट 15y एंड हियर दिस 12y इज नाउ वी हैव टू ट्रांसपोज दिस, माइनस 12y इज इक्वल टू माइनस 4 एंड माइनस 20. नाउ दिस इज 3y इज इक्वल टू व्हाट, 24 बट विद नेगेटिव साइन एंड योर y इज माइनस 8. दिस इज योर आंसर. इफ यू आर कन्फ्यूज हियर, सो सी हियर आई एम गिविंग यू समथिंग. माइनस 2 इज मल्टीप्लाइंग 2 माइनस 6y. ओके, सो हाउ आई डिड इट, आई जस्ट मल्टीप्लाइड माइनस 2 एंड 2, सो माइनस 2 एंड 2, दिस नेगेटिव साइन कम्स हियर एंड माइनस 2 एंड माइनस 2 मल्टीप्लाइज माइनस दिस 6y. This is y. And here this negative sign is here. Now solve this. You will get 2 to the 4 but negative sign. And here minus 6 to the 12. 12y but with negative sign. Okay. This minus is here. Multiplication of minus 2 and 6 becomes minus 12. And this will result minus 4. And this minus multiplication of this minus and minus becomes plus 12y. This is your answer. Here you can see I wrote it here. Now we have our next question. Question number 6. The ages of Hari and Harry are in the ratio 5:7. And 4 years from now, the ratio of their ages will be 3:4. Find their present ages. So conclude. So we have ratio of ages of Hari and Harry. So age of Hari upon age of Harry. This is Harry. Harry, so it is Harry is equal to 5 upon 7. So just consider age of Hari is, just consider or let age of Hari is equal to 5x and age of Harry is equal to 7x. And we have discussed why I consider x here. Okay, attend your online classes regularly, you will get everything here and something which is extra. It is said that 4 years from now, the ratio becomes 3:4. So after 4 years, age of Hari will be what? You have to add 4 in the present age. So that is 5x and plus 4. And after 4 years, age of Harry will be what? 7x plus 4. And it is said that the ratio is 3 upon 4. So means 5x plus 4 upon 7x plus 4 is equal to 3 upon 4. Now get the cross multiplication. So I have actually scarcity of edges here, so I'm gonna write it here. Do write it vertically, okay? So when you multiply, cross multiply these things, so 4 is now multiplying this 5x plus 4 is equal to, here this sign comes, and 3 multiplies this thing. So 3 into 7x plus 4. Okay, now our next step is, this arrow means next step. Whenever you get, you just consider this thing. Now 4 multiplies 5x, that becomes 20x. 4 multiplies 4, that becomes 16, is equal to 3 7 21, and this x plus 3 4 12. transpose this minus transpose this 21x this side, so you will get 20x minus 21, x is equal to 12 minus, and transpose the 16. Okay, this time this is what, this is minus x, which is equal to what, minus 4. So your answer is what, x is equal to 4. So it is said in the question, find the percentage. Percentage is, and we have considered present age of Hari is what, 5x, and that is 5 into this 4, that is 20 years. I think you can see that, that is 20 years. And present age of Harry is what, 7x, so multiply 7 into 4 and you will get 28 years. Here you can get 28 years. And here question number 7 is, the denominator of a rational number is greater than the numerator by 8, and if the numerator is increased by 17 and the denominator is decreased by 1, the number obtained is 3 upon 2. Find the rational number. So it is said the denominator of rational number is greater than the numerator by 8. Denominator is greater. Okay. So if numerator is, numerator is x, so we have the denominator, what is that? In our fraction, so right here in fraction, if numerator is x, denominator is what? That is x plus 8. So fraction is what? Fraction, that is our result is what? X upon, so this is x, do not get confused, this is x, again I have to draw, okay, x upon x plus 8. And it is said that when numerator is increased by 17 and denominator is decreased by 1, numerator increased by 17 and denominator decreased by 1, what we get? We get the number is 3 upon 2. It means new numerator is what? X plus 17, and this denominator is now x plus 8 minus 1, because this was the denominator. So our new fraction is x plus 17 and upon x plus 8 minus 1. Okay, so here it is said that the value of new fraction is 3 upon 2. Write it, and you know what you have to do? You have to just first solve it, make it simplified. 8 plus x becomes, and here it is, x plus 7 is equal to 3 upon 2. Now what? Cross multiplication. Cross multiplication. Now multiply it, you will get x plus 17 into 2 is equal to 3 into x plus 7. We have our new step is 2x plus 34 is equal to 3x plus 21. Now transpose these numbers, so you will get, when you transpose 3x, you will get, here it is 2x, and when you transpose 3x, this will be minus 3x is equal to 21, here it is, and transpose 34 minus 34. Okay, so here you will get minus x is equal to, and here you will get this is 3 and this is 1 minus 13. Here x is our minus 13, sorry, x is our plus 13, because this minus can cancel this minus. X is equal to plus 13. What is the fraction? Add this is the numerator. What is this? Numerator. Then denominator is, and denominator is equal to x plus 8. That is given, you can see that. So add this 13 in 8 and you will get 21. So fraction is, this is the answer, fraction is numerator upon denominator, means 13 upon 21. This is your answer.